This is going to be a follow-up video to the previous one in which I encoded some data into some music and then recorded it directly onto a digital audio tape in audio format. This is the wrong way to back up data, but I wanted to see if it was going to be actually possible to do it. Now, I need to test to see that the data is actually on here inside the music. And the best way to prove that the data was successfully recorded onto this tape is to recover it off here. The first problem is that while most motherboards do have digital audio output, they generally don't have any sort of digital audio input. So I need an SPDIF input on a computer so that I can play this tape and then capture the data off it. There are high-end sound cards that have SPDIF digital audio input, but they are expensive and outside the scope of this test. Fortunately, Apple have put digital audio input into many Macintoshes. Cleverly hidden inside the 3.5mm analog audio input jack is an optical Toslink port. Now, optical Toslink, or Toshiba Link, where the name comes from, uses a plastic optical tube to transmit digital audio. The format is the same as SPDIF, and so a simple converter can be used. Despite Toslink having been invented in the 1980s, there is still something that feels quite futuristic about passing music as light over a clear tube. We know from the previous video that this port here is not fully SPDIF compliant and uses 5 volt signaling instead of half a volt as SPDIF requires, and I don't have a cable that can convert for output. So I'm actually going to be just poking wires directly into this and then feeding that 5 volt signal into the converter box, which is expecting only half a volt, but that should be fine. Now, for the actual recording of the audio on the Macintosh, I did do some research into Macintosh bitperfect audio recording, and there is a program called Reaper that should record the bits exactly as they're coming into the digital audio port. So I'm now going to put this into motion and do the recording process. Okay, finally, 44 minutes later, and I've played the entire recording back into the Macintosh and captured it as a WAV file, full stereo. And the results are in. I've tested the recorded audio with deep sound back on the Windows machine, and sure enough, there is all the data as I saved it. So I now know that this is a backup of both the music and the data encoded into the music. So this whole process has shown that even though it's not really the right way to do it, you can actually back up data onto a digital audio tape and leave your data to the whim of whatever error detection and correction is going on inside your digital audio tape recorder. And it also means that if I want to make bitperfect copies of digital audio tapes, I now know that I can, using the Macintosh and the optical digital input. That whole process now complete, and I've backed up data onto a digital audio tape and then successfully recovered it, I thought about some other wrong ways that I could back up data. And one I'd like to try is putting data onto a mini DV digital video cassette. And these are certainly not designed to hold computer data, yet there's an easy way that it can be done. So I'd like to try that. And as a bit of a challenge, I want to back up data onto a micro MV, because there's no easy way to do this, but this is the world's smallest videotape, and that would be really interesting to try that. So that's it for now, we're done, and I thought we'd fade out with some, what's Rangoon to you, Grafton to me.
When the night comes down around your collar and the road starts coming up through your headlights, familiar landscape suddenly isn't.
It's dream time in the land of legends, and somewhere out there, Henry Lawson's taking another swig.
Inside the car, I'm making final adjustments to the viewing screen. A Holden windshield where tonight's travel thriller is being shown at 70 mph. Not so much the cars that ate Paris,